bump into a
What? Dad, you have to see this.
Oh my goodness. That's phenomenal. Gosh.
But like
these incredible underwater pictures, I've never seen such detailed pictures as this. We're never going to get pictures this good, man. I think we must go and see if we can get hold of this lady and interview her maybe. That's really amazing. Look at all the bubbles coming off them. Phew. I don't think Ben's particularly impressed by otter pictures. They're just like little doggies, little water doggies. So Danny, I just saw these amazing videos of your otter experience. So could you tell me a little bit about the great day and what happened?
Oh no, it was such an amazing, amazing day. I feel very lucky with what we have seen. We were out in Hout Bay on a dive and it was kind of the end of the day. We've already been in the water for 6 hours.
Sure.
And last stop of the day, we went to the small little bay that was quite sheltered against the wind. And as soon as we got in the water, we had this Cape Clawless Otter, like came really close to us. So we were about two or three people in
the
water.
So he approached you. He approached us. What are you guys doing here?
Exactly. As we were swimming around following this otter, he just did his own thing. He was looking at fish. He was kind of like going down and foraging and hunting. But you could really see he wasn't bothered by our presence at all. He allowed us to watch him as he dove down, caught clipfish after clipfish. It was amazing. I haven't experienced anything like this before. It was as if we weren't there. We watched him for over 40 minutes, time and time again. Dive down, catch a clipfish, come up again. Dive down, like try and catch one, come up again. And he probably had like an 80% success rate.
Wow, okay. It's amazing that they can catch these clipfish in with no claws or anything. So did he just scrabble under the rocks and grab it?
Yes.
With his paws?
So he would, like little human hands, he would go down under the rocks and then like put his one hand in, kind of feel around a little bit. And as soon as he got something, he would clench it. And then in both of his paws come up to the surface. And then on the surface, he would sit and eat his little clipfish. Kind of like also like showing us
experience.
Like above the water. Yeah, like this is my little prize. Like look. So that was amazing. I've been diving in Cape Town for about 7 years now and I've never had an otter encounter this amazing.
Well, I mean, I've heard about quite a few people having otter encounters in recent years, but I don't think any of them have really been as intimate as the ones that you had. And seeing him catch the prey and everything and eat it right in front of you. Fantastic experience. I hope I have one like that as well one day.
With our Cape Clawless otter, so I grew up in a small town called Potchefstroom, which is inland, and we also have an otter species. Would the one we get up there be the same as the ones we get here in Cape Town?
So the clawless otter that you get in the sea and the clawless otter that you get in fresh water, they're one and the same animal. So it has a distribution from south of the Sahara Desert through all the wetter parts of Africa all the way down here to the Western Cape. But they have to have access to fresh water.
Okay.
So they can't live like in the Makwaland or in Namibia because there isn't any fresh water. So everywhere that you're going to find otters on the coast here, there has to be a little stream or a seep coming into the coast because every day they need to wash themselves and drink the fresh water.
So our otters back home, they mainly eat freshwater crabs and fish. What would the ones here in Cape Town eat besides clipfish?
Whether they're freshwater or marine, they're eating mainly crustaceans and fish.
Okay.
So the freshwater ones would be eating freshwater crabs and freshwater fish. And here in the ocean, they feed a lot on rock lobsters, actually. Also take crabs. And then the ones that we get here seem to take mostly clipfish and the small sharks, the little shy sharks and the cat sharks, which is actually quite a big prey item for them. But they're slow-moving things. I mean, even as humans, we can grab them by the tail and kind of pull them out. So I guess they're quite easy prey.
You spend a lot of time in Cape Town. Would you say the otters' encounters are getting more frequent?
Yes. Decades when I was first here, I never saw otters, or I only saw them right in the distance.
Mm.
But in the last couple of years, we've seen several really good sightings. So those Greenpoint Market ones, they actually go down the stormwater pipe under Beach Road and out onto the beach. And Matthew lives close by there, and he's seen them coming out of the pipe and then feeding underneath the prom on the rocks there, and then they zoot up the pipes again to go back to the park. They have a reputation of being very, very shy and very crepuscular, only coming out at dawn and dusk.
Mm.
But people are seeing them in the middle of the day. I think they're getting much more habituated to people because they're just having to live in an environment which has people in it. And I guess they've learned that people have food and, I know that at Miller's Point, they come up onto the boats that are landing and, ask for scraps.
Would you say otters are a migratory species, or do they kind of have their own little home turf?
Otters have territories. So the females have a territory of a couple of kilometers of coastline, which has to have a freshwater source in it for them to drink and wash in. And then the males actually tend to move around. Sometimes you get family groups, but mostly the males will mate with a female and then move into the territory of another female and mate with her. And then they leave the child rearing for the poor old female. And she has to do that for quite a long time, for a year or so.
That
they raise the pups. They usually have two pups at a time. And then the female looks after them and teaches them how to catch the different types of prey. And they only become independent sometimes after only 18 months. So catching fish with your bare hands, not exactly an easy thing to try and do. So it's quite amazing that they can manage it.
If I were to want to see an otter again, like that was such a crazy encounter, but maybe want to go one morning to the beach during dusk or dawn, where would one be able to see these otters in Cape Town?
Yes, if you walk along the seashore, you see the droppings quite often. So there obviously are otter populations all around, but definitely there are ones even in the waterfront. There's a family of otters which the aquarium's actually kind of tracking and looking after. And then they're in Greenpoint. They're certainly here on the Atlantic coast of the Cape Peninsula and on all the little villages along here, wherever there's fresh water.
Okay.
And then they're in Fults Bay and Betty's Bay and the little towns on the other side of the peninsula. So I think they're pretty common. You just have to go to an area where there's a freshwater outlet and there's a place for them to hide and it's not too built up.
Mm.
And, just be quiet and just sit and wait. I mean, they're not easy to see in the water.
They're small little animals, especially during waves. A little, head peeking out can easily just be
in amongst all the kelp, and they're very hard to pick up. So usually when I've seen them, I've been lucky enough that they've come out of the water onto the rocks, and I've only spotted them when they've done that. When they're actually in the water, it's incredibly difficult to follow them.
As you say, otter encounters are becoming more and more frequent, and the risk for human-animal conflict is also becoming more. When people have these interactions, they should just be respectful towards the animals and realize it's a big privilege to view this animal in its natural habitat, so not approach it, have it approach them, and enjoy, because it's truly an amazing experience.
Absolutely. And I hope, thank you very much for sharing your experiences with us, and I hope some of our viewers get to see otters as well. But you had a utterly fantastic experience there, so well done.
And thank you so much for having me. No, I was clawless when I came to you, and I think I learned a lot about otters just from chatting with you, so thank you.
Okay, that was great.
We got the puns!